This is the Sunday Night SA Music Box with me, the Eskimo Writer. My special guest tonight is DJ Rene, an old friend of mine. We made a lot of music together back in the day, and tonight he unpacks his top three songs in his music box. I've always wanted to pick the lock on his box, now I get a chance to. Check it out. Our next guest is DJ Rene. DJ Rene, welcome to SA Music Box, where you talk about your top three songs in SA music. Now, I know you're a DJ, so you probably know millions of songs. This is going to be a great challenge for you. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. It's just awesome to be here. It's quite a setup.
Thank you. It's nice and dark on this Sunday night.
Yeah, beautiful evening.
Lovely. So what do people call you? Does everyone call you DJ Rene? Do they call you DJ?
I've been in the DJ game for about 30 years now. So at some point I've felt that the DJ part has fallen away. I'm just old for it, I'll be honest with you.
So people just call you Rene.
It's just Rene, but I'm being referred to by my company brand, Chili Funk. So some people would call me Chili and Chili Funk, and I'd always say, no, that's the company name. But yeah, I'm just Rene, keep it simple, and yeah.
Okay. It's like our postman Pat, you know, after he retired.
Yeah, it's just Pat.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So you're the owner of Chili Funk, you say. What was so appealing to this world? I know your background, right? The audience doesn't. What was so appealing about this world that it made you leave teaching? Because you were a teacher.
Yeah. That's a tough one. You know, the thing is, I'm not sure if the listeners know out there that Sivan and I know each other for quite a long time. We're actually childhood friends and, you know, very, very dear friend to me. And
well, now they know.
In our upbringing, I think the music came first. We were always music lovers. I grew up in a musical family. So the move to leave teaching was more me following my heart. Music came before teaching. Although I loved being a teacher, I loved being around kids. I love educating children. But, there was just this inner struggle within me saying, listen, this is what you love and this is what you're supposed to be doing. And, you know, I had to make a call at some point in my life and I have absolutely no regrets.
I know exactly what you're talking about. I mean, there was not much to do where we grew up, right? So we spent a lot of time experimenting on different things, music being one of those things. Mm-hmm. But tell me, what are your fondest memories of where we came from? And for the audience out there, we came from a small town called Anasia South.
Mm-hmm. You know, I always look at how my kids have it today, you know, stuck behind a tablet at times. They can't walk out into the streets. They can't play in the streets. They don't interact with each other unless you're a bit privileged and you can live in an estate lifestyle. You know, other than that, it's not safe. I won't let my son go to the shop. Yeah. And growing up in Lanesia South and the time that we grew up, that time was the time where you could just walk into your neighbor's house without making an appointment. And we interacted more with each other. So human beings connected on a much deeper level because we spent more time with each other in community. And this is how we got to speaking about music. We started sharing music. Well, not pirating, but I mean sharing music ideas. And these created the times of our lives. So now when we listen to a song, I'll give you an example. Let's say we are Lighthouse Family.
Lifted,
for example. I like Loving Every Minute. Yeah. It will take you back to that time because good things happen during those times. You think about the people that you were during those times. Magical things happen. And
like amazing things from house parties.
Yes.
To playing on the tennis courts, to losing your virginity. Whatever came, I mean, I'm not one to specify what exactly happened, but there was a range of memories.
Yeah. And losing your virginity, you will always remember that song.
So, I mean, I mentioned house parties for a reason because our exposure to the dance scene in those days, without access, I'm talking about the late 80s and early 90s, we didn't really have access to mainstream clubs in a way. We spent a lot of time at house parties, whether we were invited or not. And that's where you started playing, isn't it? That's how your my first memories of you were playing at parties.
Yeah, so that's where it all started. And ironically, that's right back where Chili Funk is right now, back to house parties. But just to give you a brief overview of the audience, house parties was where it was at. What would happen is only the DJ would have access to buying a specific record. He would go into mullahs in Hillbrow and in town, Remix Land, Koinur, and all those classic record stores. And not anyone could hear those records. The only time you could hear that kind of music and that wasn't mainstream played on the radio was to go to the house party on Saturday, or if you could make it to one of the nightclubs in Johannesburg. So, which meant that people couldn't file share music.
Yeah.
Which meant those moments were really unique and really special, because there wasn't any other place you could hear that music. You couldn't take that music home. You had to be at the club, and that's where memories were made.
Fantastic. Well, I mean, speaking of memories.
Virginity is lost.
Virginity is lost. Thank you for that, Rene. Yeah. On this lovely Sunday night, you heard it right here. Yeah. So, which is your first song for your SA Music Box?
So, I think the first song we lined up, I think, was Lira Feel Good. I think I just hesitated there because initially I had chosen Sipo Hotsticks and Harare. And the song I initially chose was Party. And it was quite a struggle for me and to choose, because for me to choose a favorite song, don't ask a DJ to do that.
Yeah.
Because basically you're musically boxing us.
Yeah. That's
so it, excuse the pun.
This
but
is welcome to SA Music Box. Yeah.
So what happens is I had to give it a bit of thought, and I really love Harare, you know, especially during the time it was released, the height of the struggle, and yet this amazing music came up. And then Feel Good came on the radio on one of my playlists, and I said, no way, nothing touches Lira Feel Good. The elements, the bass line, the lyrics, the delivery, her range in which she performs the track, just the all-round Feel Good track, uplifting the message. So, yeah, Feel Good, Lira.
Well, you got me all pumped up now, and I'm sure you got the listeners out there all pumped up. So this first track, it's for our old mates, Da Boys, who are sitting and listening at home.
What's up, guys?
Entire glass is there. This is Lira with Feel Good, DJ Rene's first choice on SA Music Box.
I just want to feel good every day. I want to wear a smile upon my face. I want to feel the joys of the day. I want to feel alive in every moment.
Right, that was awesome, Rene. Nice start to your music box. So tell me, how competitive is the DJ scene at the moment? How many gigs must a DJ do before they are classified as a musician?
like a few million. You know, it's very interesting that you bring up DJs and being a musician.
Yeah.
And I want to just tie these two in very carefully in for you.
Yeah.
So initially, what...
Obviously, I said that without prejudice. So
Yep, absolutely. So the thing is this. Because of the digital platforms available now, if you look at being a MP3 DJ, your access to the world of music over the internet is so vast. You can get anything you want on your stick right now and put it in a CD player, you're a DJ.
Instant redemption, in a way, yeah.
And because it's so easily available and it's such a cool thing to do, the technology is cheaper, you can be a DJ overnight. It doesn't take you 3 months to learn how to beat match and put a needle on a record and that kind of thing. And so now the market is saturated, obviously. What happens now is the DJ that makes it is the DJ that sets himself apart from the other DJs.
Yeah.
I want to use a young man, Avi Subban, as an example, the perfect example of how do you stand out from the crowd. And what Avi did, his father approached me and said, listen, my son wants to be a DJ. And I told him, don't do it. Send your son to varsity, let him get a real job.
Yeah.
So what Avi did is went to study music. So he became a musician. And from becoming a musician, he became a producer. And then he got into his DJ. So now Avi plays his own music in his sets. So nobody can be him, because it's his music that he's not released publicly, or I stand corrected.
Yeah.
But his unique style in his production is uplifting the whole DJ community, that the music that he's sharing is his own genre. So he's his profile is being lifted up, and now he's getting booked in all the hot places because he's not like the others.
Yeah, well, this is the thing. I think not many people know that the big international DJs, the most successful ones, mm-hmm. are very musical people.
Yep.
They can read music, they can write music, etc. It's not just about standing in front of a bunch of decks and playing.
Yep.
You still need real talent to be a great DJ.
Absolutely. And, you know, you can try gimmicks, but making your own music is a perfect way to show your true identity.
Okay.
And,
So as far as South African songs are concerned, which song, in your view, has captured your imagination? If it was possible to capture your imagination in particular.
So I'm going to definitely tell you that, you know, I'm a big fan of Tandiswa Mazwai. And,
so am I.
Yeah, and when Ngoma came out, it just gave me, in fact, I'm talking about it now and it's just giving me goosebumps because then again, the range, the delivery, the depth of the music, I think it means song or the song in Koza. I actually used the song when we set up our audiovisual setups at our events, when I test the sound system. That is the song I use because firstly, it gets me in the mood, it lifts my spirits, and it's so well produced and delivered that I get to hear my sound systems at its best. But what a song.
Fantastic. Thank you for that, Rene. Your second choice for SA Music Box tonight is Tandiswa with Ngoma.
Njengengoma wena ushaya ubusuku bonke ngiyokwenza njani ngaphandle kwakho yewena uyingoma.
Okay, that was your second choice, DJ Rene. So tell me, how does Chili Funk work with corporates and communities? How do people, what services do you offer as a company?
So I'd like to just give you a little bit of insight into.
I always get afraid when you say a little bit because I know it's
yeah, I don't stop talking.
Exactly.
My own show. So anyway, I became a DJ through, you know, my passion for music and being brought up in Motown music and eventually doing the house parties. And then I got absorbed into the club scene. And as I got older, I saw that going back to the house parties, people were not delivering quality. So they were taking people's money, but not delivering in terms of the musical knowledge, the mixing skills, and the quality of their gear.
And what about the general enjoyment factor that is going to it for?
I think reading the crowd is what they were lacking.
Yeah.
And so we said, let's get back to where we started. And it developed into Chili Funk, which is now a small AV company and a comfortable small AV company. And we do gala dinners and conferences and so forth. But now my plan moving forward is I know that the product works, so I want to try and empower young people. So I'm busy with a program where we can create little Chili Funks around the country, and we empower somebody who will be trained into our musical knowledge, our business skills, our level of excellence into a solid product. And we're looking for someone from a disadvantaged community, and hopefully we're going to expand it to 10 disadvantaged communities where we'll have small little Chili Funks in these places, but they operating on a very high level of excellence. That there's certainly a gap for that. There's always a gap for excellence.
Now, very cool. So how do young DJs or up and coming DJs get in touch with you?
info@chilifunk.co.za.
Oh, as simple as that. Now, you've played with a lot of DJs.
Mm-hmm.
Name two of the best DJs you've played with that you admire.
I'm going to have to go with Black Coffee and a young man that really, really impresses me. It's Ryan the DJ. Everyone knows who Ryan the DJ is. He's a scratch DJ. He's made it to the world finals, but the skill level on this guy is mind-blowing.
Nice.
Just, yeah.
Nice. Well, you heard it from DJ Rene. Now, I would take his advice. He knows one or two things about DJing and the DJing world and understand the nuances and what goes into it. So what's your last song for your music box?
I've decided to go something more fresh and new. And this is a very young, up-and-coming South African Congolese gentleman by the name of Worldstar Manu. And the song is called Nalingi. I like it because of the production is quite fresh. You know, it's current, but it's still a song. And the level of passion in the song and the hook is fantastic. You'll hear for yourself.
Excellent. Well, I'm looking forward to it. I can safely say I've never heard the song before. This is Worldstar with Nalingi.
My heart go boom boom for you. The way you walk, the way you talk, the way you take care of you. I swear I lost my focus when you stepped in the room. Your aura blissful beauty from your head to your shoes.
Thanks, DJ Rene, for joining me. It's always wonderful sitting next to you. I mean, we've done this for many years and for a long time. But it's always nice to unpack what's in your mind, because your mind is fascinating. It's always been fascinating. You were the guy at school that got all of us out of our comfort zones. And maybe why we're sitting here today is because you did what you did, which was just purely rebel against everything.
I think we were just a whole bunch of, I would say misfits. And we all totally went against the grain. So I won't take credit for that, because I think we were a bunch of unique souls put in the right place at the right time. And
yeah, but you were the only one who wore red socks.
Yeah, I think so. I still do.
So you can own that one.
I'll own that one, yeah.
Thank you, DJ Rene, and I wish you all the best with Chili Funk and your DJing career and your business in general, in terms of growing the industry in the party scene, the music
scene. Thank you, and thank you for having me.
All the best. And that was SA Music Box with DJ Rene, an insightful and fascinating view into the world and the culture of DJing. And home entertainment and entertainment in general. DJ industry has taken the world by storm over the last decade or so. And he's one of the best examples of somebody who's grown from a community to quite a successful DJ. And I hope you enjoyed his music box.